In our series on healthy aging, today I want to talk to you about something called loss of proteostasis and aging. So have you heard of this term, proteostasis? It's a fancy term for protein homeostasis, which means protein self-regulation. And it refers to the intricate balance within cells that maintains healthy proteins and eliminates damaged ones. This elaborate system is crucial for proper cellular function and ultimately organismal health. Unfortunately, as we age, this balance starts to tip, leading to a phenomenon called loss of proteostasis. Here's what happens. Protein misfolding over time due to various factors like cellular stress or errors in protein synthesis, some proteins lose their correct shape and they misfold. These misfolded proteins become dysfunctional, can even interfere with the proper functioning of other proteins. Inefficient removal happens. The cell has a system to identify and remove misfolded proteins, but its efficiency declines with age. This decline can be due to decreased activity of what are called chaperones. These are proteins that help other proteins to fold correctly, or reduce activity of the machinery that degrades damaged proteins. And then there's something called protein aggregates. As misfolded proteins accumulate, they tend to clump together, forming harmful aggregates. These aggregates can disrupt cellular structures and functions, ultimately contributing to various age-related diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Can we prevent or slow it? While complete prevention of proteostasis loss may not be achievable, at this moment, it is actually very interesting. Once again, the most important thing is lifestyle changes. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle with balanced diet, regular exercise, adequate sleep can help reduce cellular stress and potentially improve proteostasis. Again, dietary intervention. Certain dietary components like caloric restriction, intermittent fasting, and specific nutrients might alter some benefits in protein in maintaining proteostasis through. And then there are now recent pharmacological interventions, and these are being researched. And what the research is focused on is to develop natural compounds and even some pharmaceuticals that mimic natural compounds, and they enhance chaperone activity and promote the clearance of unfolded proteins. So here again, as we look at all the different factors that influence the aging process, it comes back to a holistic lifestyle. But it's good to understand the mechanisms, because once we understand the mechanisms, then the mechanisms can be targeted specifically through nutritional components and nutritional, what I call complements, not even nutritional supplements. They complement the lifestyle changes that we are having. I'm putting forth this series right now because I'm in the process of completely creating a healthy lifespan health span program, which will include these nine hallmarks of aging, and some of them I have yet to explain. And in these nine hallmarks of aging, bring together a complete holistic package, including some nutritional supplements and complements and very specific diets. So stay tuned. Thank you.